What's up, y'all? This your girl, Lady Louisiana, with I-10 TV, out here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, at the Liberty Lagoon, right off of Lobdell. Standing here today with your senator, very familiar, I'm sure everybody knows, Miss Yvonne Darcy. Miss Darcy, we're very honored to be out here today. I see that you got a great amount of people out here lined up in the line here at the Lagoon. Tell us a little bit about what's going on today.
Well, today what we're doing is we're calling it an evening of fellowship, fun, food. And what we did was try to give tickets to all of our churches in the district, or as many as we could. We gave them each a small amount of tickets so that they can bring the youth from their church.
I'm Eric. Hey, y'all, from Gospel Baptist Church. We are members of the youth ministry. We have shirts for me. She's a humble person, you know, sweet, kind.
So that we could get about 600 people in here, and they can have just an evening of relaxation. So it's all about the kids and doing something for them. Many of them are single mothers are here that couldn't afford to bring their kids here. So we thought we would do something like that. Normally, every year we try to take the kids somewhere. But when you take them somewhere, we usually on a bus, and we take two buses sometimes, and it's about 80 kids and 20 chaperones. But we thought that we could touch the 600 lives today. That's how many the park holds. And so that's where the idea came from. It actually came from Reverend Spurlock, who said, let's not do the bus trip, let's touch more lives. And I said, you know, Rev, that's good, because I've always wanted to take more kids. One of the things that we did that was really, 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 really good was we took a bus load of kids to the presidential inauguration. We thought it was very important to be there for kids from Louisiana to see that president, our first black president elected. So I raised money and we went on the bus up there. We took about 40 kids and chaperones, and it was awesome. We almost froze to death. It was awesome. It was a great thing, and we've taken kids all over. We've taken them to Smithsonian. We've taken them to Washington, actually where Smithsonian is. We've taken them to Los Angeles. We took them to West Angeles, which is the biggest black church in the country, where all the movie stars go, Denzel and all of that. We brought them to the Grand Canyon. So we this isn't the first time we've done something for kids. I do it all the time. It's my passion.
Now, just for some of my viewers that's not familiar with Miss Yvonne Darcy, tell them a little bit of history about you. I know you said you're a senator now for 4 years, and you're running again in October. So, I mean, with being so involved with the children in the community, I hear you saying about the churches. But why don't you tell my viewers what church are you at?
I'm actually a member of Mount Zion, First Baptist Church, but I call myself a member of all the churches because I go to all of them. Reverend Spurlock is my heart. Reverend Cyrus, I'm friends with all of them. They are spiritual leaders for me, and many, many more. Reverend Raymond Johnson. Just I can go on and on and on. Reverend Miles, and I shouldn't have started that because I'm gonna leave out a good friend like Reverend Bert Davis. But they're the rock of our community. Historically, ministers have always been involved in the civil rights fight and those kind of things. So it's normal for me to go seek counsel from ministers other than my own. And the churches are a big, big part of our community. So I love my churches, I love my ministers, and I do that all the time, and I take their counsel, and in turn, they know that I care about my people and my community. I love my people, you know, and I came from a really, really poor background. I was born and raised in a house in Easytown, which is where I live, and so I know what it's like not to have, and so I try to do something to encourage young folk and give them some hope, and I think I do that. You know, and I do it straight from my heart, but I do it because it's just the right thing to do. They are absolutely our future.
And Ms. Yvonne, with you saying that, I just want to ask, as being the senator now for 4 years, how do you feel that you have actually made an impact? I know you said you grew up in Easytown. right around the corner from here. I know my Baton Rouge viewers are familiar with that area. What do you feel like you've actually done that you feel just proud of since you've been in office for 4 years?
I feel proud of lots of things I've done, but they're big things. Like we fought this session to keep Southern University from being closed. I'm the senator, and the senator is a big, big area. I represent Southern University at the north, all the way down to LSU on the south, the community colleges in my district, and the technical colleges, and most of the public schools. And my district goes all the way to St. Gabriel. And so in that, I have two extremes. I have the poorest part of the state that's urban, and I have a more affluent part. The affluent people don't need a voice, but the people that are poor, that are downtrodden, that are struggling, that are working class, they need a voice. I believe that the most important thing that I can do for my people is be a voice and fight against the things that would hurt them and fight for the things that would help them. And so in that fight, we had the Southern University battle, which we won. We all fought very hard. We kept the bill from even being introduced on the Senate side to save Southern. But the fight is not over for Southern University. We have to continue to fight for Southern. I will not stand still and let that university be closed. Not under my watch. And the other thing that we did was, you know, we fought. Earl K. Long has to be closed because the government says it has to be closed. But we made sure that Earl K. Long, when they transitioned to the Lady of the Lake, that we don't have discrimination over there. And this year we were doing redistricting. We were redrawing the districts. And many of my colleagues wanted to draw the Lady of the Lake out of my district. And I wouldn't allow it, because when our people are transferred over there, we got to have a voice that says, hey, you're not going to discriminate against them. You're not going to treat them differently because they don't have an insurance card and they may have a Medicaid card. So if anything like that happens, I want them to call me. And it will never happen again. But I think that we've laid the groundwork so that it does not happen. And so, you know, and so Medicare and education, there's an attack on the public schools in this city and around this state. Our governor wants to privatize the prisons, and all of their buddies get rich on privatization of prisons. There's so many things that I've impacted. Prison reform, education, the attack on public schools, Southern University, the Earl K. Long system. Everywhere you look, you know, one of my reverends, Reverend Howard, says all the time, every time I try to do good, evil peeps up. And so I say that as well, because every time you think you've done some good, then the ugly head of racism and classism,
social
economics pops his head up. And so those are the ills that we fight for and against.
And so with that being said, I mean, that's a lot of things that you have done in the community. I hear you say the school system. I know a lot of my viewers here in the Baton Rouge area have a big concern with the school system, even now. So, I mean, looking forward to you being reelected in October, what can we expect from that? And with the school system.
Earlier today, I met with the Louisiana Association of Educators, and I'm real proud to say that the Louisiana Association of Educators, the Louisiana Federation of Educators, and all of the teachers' organizations have endorsed me. I'm also proud to say that I went to public school. Both of my children went to public school, and actually I have four children now, and they all went to public school because my husband has two. And my two grandchildren that are public school age go to public school. Public schools are where we all came from. They have this painting out there that public schools are bad, but good things come out of public school. You know, they said that about the ghetto when Jesus came out. No good thing could come from the ghetto. Well, I'm a product. A good thing came from the ghetto. And there are lots of other people that came from that same background. Yes, there are problems in public education, but there are problems in private as well.
Yes, ma'am.
There are problems there. And so we just have to make sure we have good teachers. I didn't have a daddy, y'all, okay? He was never there. I met him when I was 30. We never had a father-daughter relationship. But we were friends before he died. But I made it in spite of that. So I hope that I'm an example for young women especially, and young men that are in the same situation I was in, that knows about not having lights having your lights off when you go home sometime, not having enough to eat, not having your phone on, and you're having to get somebody else to turn your phone on. That's what I am. That's who I am, and that's why I fight for people that are less fortunate.
Okay. And even with that, Miss Yvonne, I know that can we look forward to seeing you out and about? I know we're getting prepared. Everyone here is getting prepared for this election that's coming up in October. Can we expect to hear some of these things, this inspirational speaking to some of these young people in any schools? I mean, what you going to be doing getting ready for this election?
I'm speaking everywhere they ask me to go.
Okay.
In fact, when I was at the LAA meeting earlier, a teacher was there from Dufrock and asked me to come speak there. Tomorrow I'll be speaking to the AKAs. The debutantes that are the young debutantes, I'll be speaking to them. I spoke last night. I was at a 35-year anniversary for Reverend Cyrus. I was the MC for that event. So I'm everywhere. I'm anywhere anybody calls me and they want me to be.
Well, we hear you right here on I-10 TV, and it's been an honor, Miss Yvonne, having you here on I-10 TV. And I'm definitely going to get out here today and talk to some of these kids. I know they're happy and excited about coming here and being able to do their swimming thing. I haven't even been here yet. Have you actually been?
I've never been here. I came, and I looked at the facility to see how everything was arranged so that it would be good for the kids and safe for the kids. And you know, it's free for the kids. Everything here is free for today for the kids. But in addition to that, the money that it costs to be here also turns over in our community as economic development as well. They have lots of people employed here, and today we paid a little bit on their salaries.
Yes, ma'am, and that is indeed a blessing. So we're going to get in. I'm going to talk to some of you people and maybe get back with you. I definitely want to do anything that I-10 TV can do to help you get prepared for October.
Okay.
We'll definitely be out there cheering for you and voting as well, okay?
That.
And I'm definitely going to get out here and do some work with you
all
today,
right.
Get everybody, make sure that get some input from some of my viewers and some of your fans too, okay?
Thank you so much,
Ms. Yvonne.
I appreciate you coming and taking your time, and I got your baby in my heart.
Yes, ma'am.
I got your baby in my heart and my thoughts and my prayers.
Okay. Thank you so much, Yvonne. All right, I-10, so we'll be back with you in just a second.
Jackie Barbara
with
New Beginnings Ministry, Church of God in Christ, under the leadership and pastor of Dr. Stella P. Righteous.
And what brings you here today?
We're just blessed and highly favored to be here to support none other than our Senator Yvonne Dorsey.
Okay. And is she a member of, what part does she play in?
Friend of our pastor, Dr. Stella P. Righteous.
And look how she said that, y'all. Did y'all see? She's a friend of our. I like that. So we definitely going to know you're going to have your vote in October.
You better know that.
Okay, how many kids did y'all bring? Because I know y'all ain't just swimming, huh?
Oh, no, ma'am. We're going to chaperone our children. We have 11 kids.
So y'all brought 11 children.
What do you
think about her as your senator?
Very good lady, very good lady. Very devoted person. She always to help her people out.
Okay, and that's always good to hear. So we know we're going to see you in October. You definitely got your votes up for Miss Yvonne Dorsey. All right, y'all. This your girl, Lady Louisiana. I'll be right back at you. While the line has slowed down a little bit, I-10, we're going to get some of these ladies. Look, she done ran, y'all. Okay, that's okay.
Great page. Hi.
So we have in front at this front door, huh?
Yes, we are. We're so excited, and all the young people in the communities are coming out from the different churches, and it's just a wonderful occasion. It is just wonderful.
Okay.
Thank God for it.
Yes, ma'am. Why don't you tell them your name and who you are.
My name is Thelma Ginn Brown, and I am a supporter, a friend, and an employer of Senator Yvonne Dorsey. Senator Yvonne Dorsey, our senator for District 14, who will always be there and in our hearts.
You heard that, and you saw that. Will always, you know.
Always.
Hello. Do it again.
Always be in our hearts.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much. We didn't pass nobody, huh? Uh-oh. Okay. Is the park usually open up until this late, or?
No.
He gonna be the first one y'all gonna see under the water, y'all.
I-10 TV in the building, you know.